Friends, in this session, I discuss about on data warehousing. The basic concept of a data warehousing is to facilitate a single version of truth for a company for decision making and forecasting. A data warehouse is an information system that contains historical and commutative data for single or multiple sources. Data warehouse concepts simplify reporting and analysis process of the organizations. Now, based on that, I start our session on characteristics of a data warehouse. A data warehouse has following characteristics, like first is subject oriented, next is integrated, next is time variant, next is non-volatile. So I discuss these characteristics one by one. So first characteristics is subject oriented. A data warehouse is subject oriented as it offers information regarding a theme instead of company's ongoing operations. The subjects can be sale, marketing, distributions, etc. A data warehouse never focuses on the ongoing operations. Instead, it put emphasis on modeling and analysis of data for decision making. It also provides a simple and concise view around the specific subject by executing data which not helpful to support the decision process. Now, second, I have discussed the characteristics is integrated. In data warehouse, integration means the establishment of common unit of measures for all similar data from the dissimilar database. The data also needs to be stored in data warehouse in common and universally acceptable manner. A data warehouse is developed by integrating data from various sources like a mainframe, relational database, or we can say flat files, etc. Moreover, it must keep consistent naming conventions, format, and coding. This integration helps in effective analysis of data. Consistency in naming conventions, attributes measures, encoding structures, etc. How to ensure. Now, I have explained one example of integrations. In this example, there are three different applications labels like A, B, and C. Information stored in these applications are gender, date, and balance. However, each application's data is stored differently. Like in application A, gender fields store logical value like male or female. In application B, gender field is a numerical value. In application C, application gender field stored in the form of character value. Same in the case with date and balance. However, after transformation and cleaning process, all this data is stored in common format in data warehouse. Now, I explain next characteristics is time variant. The time horizon for data warehouse is quite extensive compared with operational systems. The data collected in a data warehouse is recognized with a particular period and offer information from the historical point of view. It contains an elements of time, explicitly or implicitly. One such place where data warehouse data display time variance is in the structures of the record key. Every primary key contains with the data warehouse should have either implicitly or explicitly an element of time, like day, week, month, etc. Another aspect of time variant is that once data is inserted in warehouse, it cannot be updated or rechanged. Now, I explain next characteristics is non-volatile. Data warehouse is also non-volatile, means the previous data is not erased when new data is entered in it. Data is ready or read-only and periodically refreshed. This also helps to analyze historical data and understands what and when happened. It does not require transaction process, recovery, and concurrency control mechanisms. Activities like delete, update, and insert, which are performed in an operational application environment, are omitted in data warehouse environment. Only two types of data operation performed in data warehouses. These are, first one is data loading and second one is data access. Now, I have explained some major difference between application and data warehouse, or we can say operational applications and data warehouse. These differences are, in operational applications, complex program must be coded to make sure that data upgrade process maintain high integrity of the final products. While in data warehouse, this kind of issue does not happen because data update is not performed. Next is, in operational application, data is placed in a normalized form to ensure minimal redundancy, while in data warehouse, data is not stored in normalized form. In operational application, technology need to support issue of transactions, data recovery, rollback, and resource, or we can say resolutions, as its deadlocks is quite complex, while in data warehouse, it offers relative simplicity in technology. Now, I have discussed in our main topics is data warehouse architectures. The three-tier data warehouse architecture is the commonly used data warehouse design in order to build a data warehouse by including the required data warehouse schema models, the required OLAP server type, and the required front-end tools for reporting or analysis purpose, which, as the name suggests, contain three tiers, such as top tier, bottom tier, and middle tier, that are linked with one another. From bottom tier, also known as data source, through middle tier, is also known as OLAP server, to the top tier, is also known as front end tools. Data warehouse architecture is the design based on which a data warehouse is built to accommodate the desired type of data warehouse schema, user interface application, and database management system for data organization and repository structures. The type of architecture is selected based on requirement provided by the project team. Three-tier data warehouse architecture is the commonly used choice due to its detailed in structure. So the different tiers is known as like top tier, middle tier, and bottom tiers. Each tier can have different components based on the pre-requirement presented by the decision marks of the project, but are subject to novelty of their respective tier. Now, I have explained these three tiers one by one in details. So, first is bottom tier. The bottom tier in the three-tier architecture of a data warehouse consists of data repository. Data repository is the storage space for the data extract from various data sources, which undergoes a series of activities as a part of ETL process. ETL stands for extract, transform, and load. As a preliminary process before the data is loaded into the repository, all the data relevant and required are identified from several sources of the systems. These data are then cleaned up to avoid repeating or junk data from its current storage units. The next step is to transform all this data into a single format of storage. The final step of ETL is to load the data on the repository. Now, next tier is middle tier. The middle tier is the tier with the OLAP servers. The data warehouse can have more than one OLAP server, and it can have more than one type of OLAP server model as well, which depends on the volume of data to be processed and the type of data held in bottom tier. There are three types of OLAP server models, such as first is ROLAP. It's known as Relational Online Analytical Processing. Is a model of online analytical processing which carries out an active multidimensional breakdown of data stored in a relational database. Instead of redesigning a relational database into a multidimensional database, this applied when repository contains of only a relational database system in it. Next is MOLAP, means Multidimensional Online Analytical Processing, is another model of online analytical processing that catalogs and comprises of directories directly on its multidimensional database systems. This applied when the repository consists of only the multidimensional database system in it. Next one is HOLAP, means Hybrid Online Analytical Processing, is a hybrid of both relational and multidimensional online analytical processing model, when the repository contains both the relational database management system and the multidimensional database management system HOLAP is the best solution for a smooth functional flow between the database system. HOLAP allows storing data in both the relational and multidimensional formats. The middle tier acts as an intermediary component between the top tier and the data repository, that is the top tier and the bottom tier respectively. From the user's standpoint, the middle tier gives an idea about the conceptual outlook of database. Now, I have discussed on our last tier is top tier. The top tier is a front-end layer, that is the user interface that allows the users to connect with the database systems. This user interface is usually a tool or an API call, which is used to fetch the required data for reputering, analysis, and data mining process. The type of tool depends purely on the form of outcome expected. It includes like reporting tools and analysis tools and query tools or data mining tools. It is essential that the top tier should be uncomplicated in terms of usability. Only user-friendly tools can give effective outcomes. Even when the bottom tier and middle tier are designed with at most care and clarity, if the top tier is enabled with untrained front-end tools, then the whole data warehouse architecture can become a total failure. This makes the selection of the user interface, or we can say front-end tools, as the top tier, which will serve as a face of the data warehouse system, a very significant part of three-tier data warehouse architecture design process. So I hope you can understand this three-tier in data warehouse. Now I explain data warehouse database. The central database is the foundation of the data warehousing environments. This database is implemented on the RDBMS technology, or we can say this kind of implementation is constrained by the fact that traditional RDBMS system is optimized for transactional database processing and not for data warehousing. For instance, ad hoc query, multi-table joins, aggregates, and resource instances, and so down performance. So here, alternative approach to database are used as listed here. The first one is, in data warehouse, relational database are deployed in parallel to allow for scalability. Parallel relational database also allow shared memory or shared nothing model on various multiprocessor configurations or massively parallel processors. Next is, new index structures are used to bypass relational table scan and improve speeds. Next is, use of multi-dimensional database, or we can say MDDBS, to overcome any limitations which are placed because of the relational data model. Now I explain the example is access base for Oracle. Now I explain sourcing, acquisition, cleanup, and transformation tools, or we can say ETL. So in that, data sourcing, transformation, and migration tools are used for performing all the conversions, summarization, and all the chains need to transform data into a unified format in data warehouse. They are also called extract, transform, and load, or we can say ETL tools. Their functionality includes, first one is anonymize data as per regularity stipulations. Next one is eliminating unwanted data in operational database from loading into data warehouse. Next one is search and replace common name and definition for data arriving from different source. Next one is calculating, summarizing, and derived data. Next one is, in case of missing data, populate them with defaults. Next one is deduplicated, repeated data arrive from multiple data source. These extract, transform, and load tools may generate on jobs, background jobs, mobile programs, shell scripts, etc. that regularly updates data in data warehouse. These tools are also helpful to maintain the metadata. These ETL tools have deal with challenge of database and data heterogeneity. Now I explain. Next topic is metadata. The name metadata suggests some high level technology concepts. However, it is quite simple. Metadata is data about data, which defines the data warehouse. It is used for building, maintaining, and managing the data warehouse. In the data warehouse architecture, metadata play an important role as it specifies the source, uses, value, and features of data warehouse data. It also defines how data can change and process. It is closely connected to data warehouse. Therefore, metadata are essential integrities in transformation of data into knowledge. Metadata helps to answer the following questions. First one is, what table, attributes, and key does the data warehouse contains? Next one is, where did the data come from? Next is, how many times do data get reloaded? Next one is, what transformations were applied with cleanings? Metadata can classified into two categories. First one is technical metadata, which includes this kind of metadata contains information about warehouse, which is used by data warehouse designers and administrators. Next one is business metadata, means this kind of metadata contains details that gives end users a way easy to understand information stored in the data warehouse. Now I explain data marts. A data mart is an access layer which is used to get data out to the user. It is presented as an option for large size data warehouse, as it takes less time and money to build. However, there is no standard definition of data mart. It's differing from person to person. In a simple word, data mart is a subsidiary of a data warehouse. The data mart is used for partition of data, which is created for a specific group of users. Data marts could be created in the same database as the data warehouse or physically separated database. Now, I summarize these sessions. Data warehouse is an information system that contains historical and commutative data from single or multiple source. Data warehouse is subject oriented as it offers information regarding subject instead of organization's ongoing operations. In data warehouse, integration means the establishment of a common unit of measures for all similar data from the different database. Data warehouse is also non-volatiles, means the previous data is not erased when new data is entered in it. A data warehouse is time variant, as the data in a data warehouse has high shelf life. There are five main components of data warehouse. First one is database, second is ETL tools, third one is metadata, fourth one is query tools, fifth one is data marts. The data sourcing, transformations, and migration tools are used for performing all the conversion and summarizations. In data warehouse architecture, metadata plays an important role as it specifies the source, uses, values, and features of data warehouse data. So I hope you can understand the knowledge of data warehouse. So thank you friends watching this video. I hope you can understand basic concepts of data warehouse and three-tier architecture of data warehouse. Thank you.